We're told, the story is told, that Moses was one day, he was tending to his flock, and he suddenly realized that one of the sheep disappeared. Now that alone, between thousands of sheep, to identify and recognize that one sheep had disappeared is already quite a feat of sensitivity. And he went looking, and he found the sheep had wandered off from the flock quite a distance, seeing the sheep is sipping water from a brook of water. He realized that the sheep was thirsty. So besides feeling sad for the sheep, he let the sheep finish drinking. He picked it up and put it on his shoulders and carried it back to the flock. So this, which is a midrashic narrative, tells us that when God saw that, he said, if that's a man that can be so sensitive to one sheep, and nobody's looking, and it's just a sheep among thousands, he's the person I will entrust my people to. He will be their leader. So the first quality and virtue and feature of a leader is sensitivity. Most of us would not necessarily begin with that. Sensitivity, not ambition, not drive, not talents, not strengths. Those are all good things. But the first thing is sensitivity, if you don't have the empathy, which means essentially it's not about you, not about the ego. It's not about your arrogant contribution to this world, but it's your sensitivity and the feeling for another. As I said, Moses did not have to go pursue that sheep. Who would even know? And yet, that's what mattered to him. That's what Moses represented. That's why he was such a great man. Do you know that Moses had a speech defect? He couldn't speak clearly. As a matter of fact, the Bible tells us that when Moses was chosen by God to be the Savior, to come to redeem the Jews from Egypt, he said, I'm a man of no words. I have a speech defect. He said there are different ways of expressing himself. I cannot speak. Choose my brother Aaron. Choose someone that's a good speaker. And interestingly, Moses is the man that God wants. And it says that Elo Hadvarim, these are the words that Moses spoke. There's no person on earth whose words have been repeated more than the man of no words called Moses. How is that possible? Because God responds to Moses. You know what he says to him? Who gave man a mouth to speak? You think I'm looking for an orator? You think I'm looking for a wordsmith? Someone who knows how to express themselves? I need someone who's going to convey a higher truth than themselves. I give a man a mouth to speak. You be my channel. I will speak through you. It's not about you. It's not about your wisdom. It's about a higher truth. And that's the man of all people on earth God chose, a person who could not speak on his own.